Hello viewers, today we are going to talk on the subject Introduction to Family Resource Management. And the most important topic we are going to discuss is the management process. The objectives behind the management process is to acquire knowledge about the meaning of management process and its use. Also, to gain insight into the steps of the management process. At the same time, understand the importance of each step in detail, that is, planning, controlling, and evaluation. Let's go ahead and look into the different aspects we are going to cover in this session. So let's move and discuss on the first step, that is the introduction to the management process. The term management has different meaning in different perspective. The meaning varies with the person to whom it is referred to. In general, we can say that management is a process that involves planning, managing resources to accomplish a set objective and measuring the results they need to get. When we say resources, we mean to say not only the human resource but also the other resources such as financial resources, materials required, machineries involved, etc., that are needed to accomplish a task or an objective. Management is a very popular term and has been used extensively for all type of activities and mainly for taking charge of different activities in any enterprise or organization. The basic aim of managing is to achieve certain objectives and goals. Let's see what are the important steps in management or what is the management process all about. We know that the management process includes planning, controlling, implementing, and evaluating. Let's understand the meaning, definition, and use of management process. Management is an activity consisting of a distinct process. The management process, which is primarily concerned with the important task of goal achievement. In general, it is defined as a series of actions or operations conducting to an end. The logic behind management process is that particular functions are performed in a sequence through time. In other words, whatever functions are performed by a manager and the sequence in which they are performed is designated as management process. Management is a process of planning, controlling, and evaluating the use of the resources of the family. That is, human resources like knowledge, abilities, energy, skills, and interest. Non-human resources like money and time for the purpose of attaining the family goals against the set standards and the values. Management is a planned activity directed towards the realization of values and the satisfaction of needs. It results in the accomplishment of desired end or goals. Let's talk about the uses of management. why do we use management and why is it necessary to use management? We need to know. So the first thing which comes to our mind is to bring about change in an orderly way. Second, to achieve desired goals and purposes by using resources to an advantage. The third thing is to promote meaningful, effective living of individual and families. And the last is to control the events of life and influence the outcomes of situation. Let's go ahead and look the steps involved in the management process. The first step is planning. Planning, the importance of planning, the techniques involved in planning, and the types of planning. Planning is the first step in the management process. It covers a wide range of decisions dealing with family activities, resources, and changing family needs. Because of its important role in management, planning is considered the key activity in the management process. Planning is necessary for the effective organizing and control activities that can take place. It provides the basis for the other managerial activities like organizing, controlling the plan in action, and evaluating the results. Planning involves problem solving, which includes the steps in decision making already, obtaining information and formulating possible courses of action, considering consequences of each alternative, and selecting the course of action that seems the best. A plan is a future forecast of some future action. It suggests the course and the method of action that are thought to be best for the solution of the problem. In making plans, decisions are made, such as what are the actions necessary to achieve the desired objective, why each of these actions is necessary, who is responsible for each action, and when, where, and how each action will take place. To determine these things, planners must search for available alternatives and then make their selection. Good communication aids in coordinating activities and making plans run smoothly. A plan of action shows the activities that must be performed to reach goals. All plans should be made to fit the needs of the individual or family group. They should be flexible enough to meet the necessary changes, realistic in the use of available resources. The next we are going to look into is the types of plans. There are many ways where the plans can be classified according to the time dimension. They are short-term plans. These plans extend up to 1 year. The second is medium-term plans. These plans are for more than 1 year but less than 5 years. Third, long-term plans. These plans are of 5 years or a longer period. Plans could not be classified under the terms of function like production and marketive planning. The fourth type of plan is the operative plans. Operative plans are largely concerned with actual operations and are produced by line managers. These plans are not the most important part of the formal planning. The fifth type of planning is strategic planning. The strategic planning is a key document. It is the main and important plan for the whole company and is the plan of chief executive and his top management team. It will embrace in the broad terms the actions, describe those in detail in individual plans, and in addition will show the actions that have been taken over and above those falling under the responsibility of a line manager. The sixth type of plan is a tactical plans. A tactical plan is concerned with what the lower level units within each division must do, how they must do it, and who is in charge at each level. Tactics are the means needed to activate a strategy and make it work. These plans usually span 1 year or less because they are considered short-term goals. Steps in management process. The second step involved is controlling, which is called a phases and supervision. What is controlling? Controlling in the management process is the activity that aids in putting and keeping the plan in action, that keeps the organization moving. It acts as a device to channel activity in the direction of the desired results. Controlling involves a careful observation of performance. It is checking work and performances to be sure that the procedure where it involves tangible work or subtle relationships is present in the planned direction. Controlling also includes making changes when the change is necessary. This checking may concern the quality of the work or cost in terms of either money or time. Controlling thus calls for flexibility in thinking and planning rather than a rigid and set pattern of action. It also requires that the group welfare to be emphasized but not at personal desires. With controlling, coordination is also important. So, coordinating is another means of control. It unifies activities and parts of an enterprise or plan into a harmonious and workable whole. It helps to give individuals working together a feeling of security and understanding of the total situation and of the necessity for cooperation if the best results are to be achieved. Skillful direction and guidance are needed to help control the plan in operation. Direction and guidance are so closely related that at times they merge. A thorough knowledge of available resources and decision is the best way, the essence of control in the management process. Controlling is the step as carrying out the plan without recognition that many new decisions are required, which may result in changes in the plan. As a plan is put into action, unless it is very simple one, it is usually necessary to elaborate the decisions made in the planning step. This elaboration comes in connection with the phases of the control step. They are energizing, checking, and adjusting. The phase of energizing or initiating or sustaining the action is one phase of management. It is well known that people differ a great deal in ability to get started on their plans and to carry them through. In back of energizing may be the relative strength or the weakness of the goal towards which a person is working. Setting intermediate goals may be helpful in energizing actions, since they provide an opportunity for rapid accomplishment with its accompanying satisfaction. A second phase of controlling the plan in action is checking. Checking is the progress of the plan, which is done automatically in many respects. For example, nearly every home has a kitchen clock. It is necessary to have standards or intermediate goals at strategic points as a basis for checking. It may be necessary to have devices to call attention for checking. For example, the clock mentioned in the above example is a checking device. The third phase of the control step is, if necessary, adjusting the plan, thus making fresh decisions. Conditions may change. For example, baked potatoes have been planned for dinner. The homemaker has less time for preparation than she had expected, so she quickly substitutes the small potatoes boiled in the jackets. Control of delegated plans, which is called as supervision. When the plan is delegated to others, supervision usually becomes important. It may also have one or two quite different purposes. If the technical aspects of the job and particularly the resulting end product are uppermost in the mind of the manager, the process is called directing. If, on the other hand, the effect of supervision on the person's development is uppermost, the process is guiding. The references agree that direction should be positive, clear, and as few as possible. No one can ever give clear directions unless the person thoroughly understands the process that he or she is directing. Directions will naturally vary in degree of detail, in form and in time when given, as well as in tactfulness. The form of directions may be written, oral, demonstrated, or a combination of the three. The third step involved in the management process is evaluation. The importance of evaluation and the types of evaluation. Evaluating constantly looks towards both the process of management and the result. Evaluation, as a distinct phase of the management process, goes beyond merely checking as such. It takes a look at the final results and judges them to be good. It is a broader, longer view and look beyond the activity to its impact on the total pattern of living. Evaluation sees beyond the momentary mistakes, confusions, or changes needed to the excellence of the accomplishment. The effectiveness or the efficiency of management requires analysis, honesty, and objectivity. It requires a sound basis of judgment. The managerial activities such as planning, organizing, controlling, and evaluating, usually flowing along in sequence, are not separate and distinct from each other. They form a cycle of action from planning to evaluating and back to planning. Thus, the activity of evaluating brings the sequence back to the point at which it started and completes the cycle. Four purposes in evaluation. They are to see what has been achieved, to serve as a basis for the next plan, to serve as a basis for modifying the overall plan, and to gain new general insight. There are generally two types of evaluation, the overall variety and a more detailed kind. The first, recognizing the general quality of the job done, may be quite casual. the more detailed type of evaluation, that is determining the degree of excellence of the managerial job, is a further step which is more revealing than the first. It is an attempt towards accuracy of judgment and consists of separate evaluation of different parts of the management. There are other categories of evaluation also, like formal and informal evaluation. Formal evaluations are pre-planned systematic attempts against the set the goals. The majority of assessments in educational settings are formal in nature. Typically, formal assessments are used in combination with goals and objective set forth at the beginning of a task. Informal evaluations. Informal evaluation are those assessments that result from the spontaneous day-to-day observation of how workers behave and perform in job. When manager conducts informal assessment, he doesn't necessarily have a specific agenda in mind, but is more likely to learn different things about workers, their attitudes, their commitment, and the capabilities. I hope you all enjoyed this session. Till now we have known about the family resource management, the family characteristics involved in the management, factors motivating management such as values, goals, standards, and decision making. Also, in the same previous lesson, we have learnt about the resources in the family, and thus would like to conclude the subject resource management by knowing the management process in detail. I hope you all enjoyed this session. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.